I'm going to let you sing one more song after the scripture is read, and I'm going to come back and share what God has laid on my heart this morning.
Amen.
We have two scriptures we want to come from this morning. 1 John 1 and 7 and Colossians 1 and 14. Colossians 1 and 14, 1 John 1 and 7.
1 John
1
and 7.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. Easy. Y'all can't find 1 John.
I got it. The book keeps slipping away from me.
Okay.
But if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another. Mm-hmm. And the blood of Jesus Christ, his son, cleanseth us from all our sins.
Amen.
Amen.
Colossians 1, 14. Colossians 1, 14. Come on, somebody read it. Page is still turning.
In whom we have redemption through his blood, forgiveness of sins.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. After the next election, I want to talk from the subject. Are you covered by the blood? Are you covered by the blood?
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
Why should I feel?
Yes.
Discouraged.
All right.
And why should the shadow? Because I'm free. His eye is on the sparrow. And I know that he watches over me. Our Father and our God, thank you for the presence of your Holy Spirit. Father, endow me with power from on high, that I might be able to speak a word to your people. You know, Father, if you hear me at this hour, I'd be so careful to give you my praise. Remove self, dear Lord. Fill me with your Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Why don't you give the Lord a great big hand of applause? I don't know what you come to do, but I come to lift up the name of Jesus. I want to say, Brother Andre, Brother Johnson is still doing it. Amen. You got folk that rooted in the Word, saved and sanctified. God will use them to the highest. Amen. First, giving honor to God, whom honor is due. Giving honor to you, my brothers and sisters in Christ. Sister Edwards, Deacon Wilder, and Brother Charles. Good morning. It's good to be on the mountain one more time. God does not have to allow me this opportunity, but I'm glad that he did.
Yeah.
When I saw Leah walk in the door with a young man, I thought she had a date. Because he looked so handsome.
Amen.
And then he walked in, I didn't see Sister David. I said, what's going on here? And then I was reminded who he was. Amen. So it's good to see them this morning. My brothers and sisters, this morning we're going to focus on two different scriptures using the first chapter of each. Amen?
Amen.
1 John chapter 1, verse 7, and Colossians 1, 14. I want to use for the subject this morning, are you covered by the blood?
All right.
Amen.
Are you covered by the blood?
Now,
I don't mean the blood that somebody slaps you beside the head and your nose bleeding. That's not the blood I'm talking about.
All right.
Amen?
Amen.
The blood is somewhat to the Christian as the password to a game. In many games, members are referred to as blood brothers. Amen?
Amen.
You cannot become part of the group unless you shed blood.
Yes.
Your own or someone else's blood. As we turn to the Bible, we find that it speaks much of blood. Not without blood, there is no salvation. Without anointing blood, you cannot be saved.
Yes.
The blood of Christ opens the way for you to meet God.
That's right.
On friendly terms.
Amen.
No refusal can be given it. No relief from the burdens of sins can be without it. The blood, for those who trust in it, shuts the gates of an eternal hell and opens the gate of heaven. In the Bible, we know the occasion for the blood marked in several areas. In the 8th chapter of Leviticus, we see Aaron and his son receiving the blood mark when the public inducted into the office of priesthood. We are told in verse 22-24 that he brought the ram of consecration, he slew it. And Moses took of the blood of it. And he put it on the tip of Aaron's right ear, and upon the thumb of his right hand, and upon the great toe of his right foot.
Amen.
And he brought Aaron's sons. And Moses put it upon the tip of their right ear, and upon the thumbs of their right hands, and upon the great toes of their great right feet. Amen?
Amen.
Aaron and his sons had the covering of the blood for a purpose. Are you covered by the blood?
Yeah, right. Oh,
the priest's ears were blood marked that they might only hear for God and hearken all divine communication.
Oh, yes.
Blood marks upon the thumbs of the priest's right hands signifies the act only from God.
Yes.
Being set apart to God to be occupied with his affairs.
Mm-hmm.
The blood mark meaning the consecration of the walk before God was put upon the toe of the right feet of all the priests so that they should take all their steps to God.
Yeah.
Are you covered by the blood? Do you wait and listen for directions from God? Do you act only for God, or do you allow your steps to take you where God leads you? Are you covered by the blood? Do you have the blood mark? In Exodus 12:13, God said, when I see the blood, I will pass over. The blood of Christ does the same for every sinner now who takes it home to himself in spiritual reality. It both shelters and it separates. Now, as people say that they're covered in the blood, really don't understand. Because, see, when you're covered in the blood, you don't have to worry about nothing. I don't care what comes against you, God is there to fight your battle. You see, people say that they've been washed in the blood of the Lamb. Yeah, people say that. I'm washed, blood of the Lamb. I'm saved, sanctified, and filled. But they're a bunch of hell raisers. Y'all know what I'm talking about. People want to see the church fall. You know, it's amazing to me who folk listen to today. They'll listen to all the garbage out there in the street, but won't listen to the Word of God.
Amen.
The reason your families are not being blessed is because you're not heeding God's Word.
Amen.
God holds us account how we lead our family.
Amen.
Am I right about it?
Come on, Pastor.
People have the attitudes when somebody tried to correct them. Uh-huh. And I don't have a problem with constructive criticism.
Amen.
I believe all of us need it every now and then.
Amen.
Amen. But when you get a person, you can't tell nothing.
Come on.
I'm scared of that person. When you meet people say, I have a right, I know everything. That's a person I don't want to be around.
Amen.
Tell me, if I had a man tell me right here in the church, I put my pants on just like you do.
Right.
Amen. Can't tell me nothing. I have to pray for him.
Amen.
See, God got a way to get your attention.
Oh, yeah.
See, you walk around here like you're the baddest. Thank God they don't take one step. God will knock you down.
Amen.
Am I right about it?
Amen.
Are you covered by the blood? God leads you. Are you converted by the blood?
Yes.
Do you have the blood mark? Yes. Amen.
Amen.
Are you covered by the blood? Why is it important under the blood? Yes. We're told in Hebrews 9:22, not without blood, there's no remission of sin. Not without blood, there's salvation for man. There shall no man in heaven out of any age, from any nation, apart from the precious blood of Jesus.
Yes.
Despised by the word of the unbelief. Not without blood, there's redemption. Amen. 1 Peter 1:29 says, you were redeemed with the precious blood of Christ. In spiritual redemption, your soul is brought into the position of freedom from the penal sins and the purchase of the power of the blood.
Yeah.
Amen. The blood of Christ is sufficient to pay for our sins.
Oh, yeah.
If you don't see everybody, you know what people get me? They come to church and they feel like just because you're in church, you're going to be all right.
Yeah.
Folk come to church the same and leave the same. I just don't understand when you don't get happy sometimes.
Amen.
You would think some song would make you cry sometimes. You think the word would touch you sometimes.
Amen.
You could think you could pat your feet every now and then sometimes.
Come on,
you think you could say thank you sometimes.
Come on,
you think you could give beyond attempts sometimes.
Amen.
You think you could keep glorifying God
sometimes.
Amen.
Amen.
We act like God owes us something. God don't even owe us the air we breathe.
Amen.
We're not deserving of it.
Amen.
Amen. And then what's happening in church today, churches are now taking pastors to court. Pastors taking churches to court.
Yeah, yeah.
And we wonder why we can't lead folk to Christ. We got more hell going on in the church than they got going on outside of the church.
Amen.
See, people sit here and they say amen, but the amen is supposed to bear witness to the truth.
That's right.
Don't be hollering amen if you don't understand what I'm saying.
All right.
Because when you say amen, God's going to hold you accountable.
Yeah.
People got this thing about don't tell me. Mm. As soon as you fall down, I stretch my hand to thee. What if God just turned away from us? Mm. Am I right about that?
Amen.
Got folks say they get attitudes because you call them on the phone and tell them to come to church. I know what they did. Be in church, I won't have to call you. Amen. Then guess what? The devil gives me too sometimes, Brother Andre. I say, I don't know what that joker said to me the last time I called him. Why I got to call him?
Yeah.
But the Lord said, call him in.
Amen.
Just see, you miss your blessings when you're on the devil's side.
Amen.
But when God's on your side, keep doing what he told you to do.
Amen.
Amen. You might not understand it. You might can't see it. But sooner or later, it's going to make a difference.
Oh, yeah.
St. John was on program at the BCU for the dedication of the chapel.
Amen.
Sister Edwards and Sister Costello was in the Daytona Times serving with the president. And somebody said to me, I saw your little church. Y'all got that, man.
Yeah.
Saw your little church folk. Look there, look at Cook Man. Little church, God ain't got no little church.
Amen.
Ain't but one church and that's God's church. We're nothing but a branch doing what God has called us to do. Don't you need to stop putting numbers together, denominations together. We all got a purpose to do. Am I right, Nate? Well, they said, I saw your little church up there trying to be something. I said, we just trying to serve God. That's all we trying to do. See, when you get to heaven, it ain't going to be no little churches and big churches. Amen. Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Somebody know the word. See, folks gotta stop letting folks fool you. See, it ain't gonna be how wonderful you sung. It ain't gonna how it's gonna be how you lived your life. Amen. People say, well, preacher, get me to heaven. I can't put nobody in heaven. I'm trying to get myself there. Amen. I got a problem trying to get me there. So Sister Ellis came live on my back. She got to get there for herself.
Amen.
Amen. People say, well, you can buy your way. Because if you could buy your way, I would have put a down payment a long time ago. Am I right about it?
Amen.
So you got to be prayed up. Pray for them to despitefully use you. Pray for them to curse you. And God says, I'll fight your battle. And you know what I found out? There are some people not going to get right on this side. But the Bible says that every tongue will confess.
Amen.
Every knee will bow.
Every knee will bow.
It ain't gonna be over until it happens.
Yeah.
Amen. And then you got folk becoming where they don't want to give to Christ. Do you know that little you got, God can take from you?
Hallelujah.
Walking around here like you talking about you got it saved up. One stay in the hospital will take every dime you got.
Amen.
People give in offering. And they hold back. A week ago, I was up at the service station. White lady ran up to me. She said, I got a $45 gas card you can get for $25. She said, give me the $25. I said, oh, no, baby. Come on in the store. I want them to read that card first.
Amen.
So you get the $25, they gone, and you stuck with $10 worth of gas.
That's right.
But next year, $45, $48 was on the card. I'm glad to give them $25. God bless you. When I didn't pump my gas, full tank. Amen. Ain't nothing but a blessing. She needed the cash and I needed the cash.
Amen.
Amen. I ain't did nothing illegal.
That's right.
Amen. But you have to watch how folk beat you. They just buried a 4-year-old yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
And the preacher was asked, will this child make it into heaven? That child already in heaven.
Amen. Amen.
I think it's some sick folk to pray out on a child. Now you want to mess with me, mess with children and senior citizens. I got a problem with you. Amen. Because they can't defend themselves. Amen. And then people say, why are you always talking about that? Well, you better talk about it because it's happening every day. Our children are being raped. They ain't safe in schools. Not even on the school bus.
Amen.
What happened to the family? It takes a village to raise a family. You say something to somebody, child, now you got to fight the parents.
That's right.
Amen. That's my baby. Don't you get it?
Yeah.
Don't know how we get.
It's
Lord, help me today. Are you covered by the blood?
Oh, yeah.
If you're converted by the blood as sinners, you can be justified by counted righteousness. We're told in Romans 5:9, being now justified by his blood, we shall be saved from the wrath through him. If you are covered by the blood, you can have peace with God.
Oh, yes.
Colossians 1:20 says, Christ made peace through the blood of his cross. Amen. When you see we're making walking right, holding my head in spite of situation, laughing when it seems that I should be crying, it is because I'm covered by the blood of Jesus. Amen. If you're covered by the blood, you can overcome the devil. Revelation 12:11 says, and they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb. Yes, yes. The blood that stamps out every charge that Satan brings against you. Yes. It is the blood that reconciles a sinful man to a holy God.
Oh, yes.
Paul says in Romans 5:10, when we were enemies, we were reconciled by God by the death of his Son.
Oh, yes.
The covering of the blood can cause us to have hope.
Yes, yes. That
is built on Jesus and his word.
Hallelujah.
The blood, oh, the blood, nothing else can wash away my sin.
Yes.
Nothing else can make me whole again.
Yes.
Nothing but the blood of Jesus.
Yes.
Am I right about it?
Yes.
You see, when you've got Jesus on your side,
yes. You
got to pray for them that despitefully use you.
Oh, yes.
You got to be able to reconcile with your brothers.
Yes.
Oh, come on, church, y'all know what I'm talking about.
Oh, yes.
You got to do it and do it now.
Yes.
You got to accept Jesus as your Savior.
Oh, yes.
Well, I came to Jesus as I was.
Oh, yes.
I was weary, worn, and sick.
Yes.
Nothing but the blood.
Yes.
Jesus' blood and gave me life.
Yes.
From the bonds of sin,
saved
from slavery, it has set us free. Free to be a dying world, to come to the belief that Jesus is the Christ, that he died and buried and rose on the third day, that whosoever will can have the blood mark. Are you covered in the blood? I stopped by to tell you this morning that I've been washed in the blood of the Lamb, that I'm saved and I'm filled with the Holy Ghost. Oh Lord, this love that I have, the world didn't give it. The world can't take it away. This joy that I have, the world didn't give it. The world can't take it away. Oh Lord, y'all gonna look for me one day, and I'm gonna be gone home. To meet the Lord for myself. I want to hear him say, servant of God, your job well done. You ran the race. You finished your course. Now come on up a little higher, and I'll make you ruler over a few things. I want to let y'all know something. I haven't always been saved. I was lost, sinking deep in sin, but nothing but the blood rescued me. And all right, I'm so glad that I'm wrapped up, tied up in Jesus. He's my friend. When I got no friends, he bred in a starving land. Somebody said that he walked in dry places. Ain't it all right? David said, if I had wings like a dove, I'd fly away and be at rest. Ain't it all right? I'm so glad that I've been washed. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Fell down sometimes, but I say, Lord, just give me the strength to get back on my feet. I fell short of what you called me to do, but if you give me one more chance, I'll do what you're telling me to do. I'll go where you want me to go.
Yeah.
Amen. Blood, nothing but the blood. See, everybody looks to everything but what they ought to.
The
But you need to look to Jesus.
Yes.
You need to see what makes you white by four.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It ain't your detergent.
Mm.
It ain't Clorox bleach.
Yay.
But it's the blood of Jesus.
Yeah.
As we open the doors of the church, there might be someone here today. You can come as a candidate for baptism. Come under your Christian experience. We invite you to come. Will you come? Let us stand.
The blood that Jesus shed for me.
Here you go. Jesus Christ.